Hello children, welcome to our English teacher video lessons. In our previous session, we learnt about direct speech and indirect speech, how to change the statements given in present present tense from direct speech into the indirect speech, children. Isn't it? Shall we move to our next session, children? Here, we have taken interrogative forms, and these interrogative forms are from present tense. In all four forms of present tense. Now let us see how to change these interrogatives that are given in present tense from direct speech into the indirect speech. Okay, children. Okay, before going into the session, I would like to ask you one question, children. Do you know how many kinds of interrogative sentences are there? Yeah, two kinds. One that starts with WH, and the second one which starts with helping verbs, auxiliary verbs or modals, children. Okay. What are the WH words? Come on, tell me. Yeah. When, where, what, why. Yes. How, which, all these. All these we call them as interrogative words, question words. And come on, give examples for the helping verbs. Yeah. All be forms, possessive forms, do forms, modals, come under auxiliary verbs, children. And I told you already about be forms, possessive forms, do forms in our previous session, children. Now let's come to once again, let's revise this. What are be forms? Yeah, B1, am, is, are. B2, was, were. Possessive forms, as, have, had, participle. And do forms, do, does. And past tense, do form, did. And verb 3, done. Okay. Next, modals, can, could, will, would, shall, should, may, might, all these come under both as auxiliary verbs and modals, children. Here, we have two kinds of interrogatives, finally, okay, that starts with WH word and another one that starts with helping verb. We shall go one after one, children. And today in our class, I am going to tell you about only interrogatives from present tense only, and in the later session we can go for other sentences, children. Okay, and these present tense in questions that start with the WH word and also with the auxiliary verb. Let's go one by one, children. Shall we start? And all these examples are from our daily conversation only. No new sentence is there, no new question is there. Whatever we ask you, children, and whatever you ask your friends, and whatever your parents ask you, all these sentences are from our life situations only. So there is no difficulty at all for you. No need to feel any difficulty, children. Enjoy the class. Now let us have a look at the first example, children. How to convert interrogatives from direct speech into the indirect speech. Direct speech. The teacher said, "Why are you late to the class?" You might have experienced this so many times in your classroom, students, isn't it? Suppose if you come late, generally we ask for the reason, no, children? In the same way here, the teacher said, "Why are you late to the class, children? Why are you late to the class?" Then you try to give any one reason in response to the teacher's question, children. Okay, now how to change it into reported speech? Let us see. The teacher inquired of why he was late to the class. I told you already, present simple changes into past simple. But the only thing you should keep in your mind is there is change in the word order, children. So, how does it change? Let us see. The teacher said, in place of said, you write inquired because it's a former situation. So, inquired of, and we should add this of inquired of, why? Same question word, there is no change in the order of the question word. Question word as it is, here we write why. And here, yes, the word order changes. You refers to listener, no? Who is the listener here? Student. Student may be a boy or a girl. So, as it's not being given here, you can write either he or she. So, why he? This comes here next to the question word here. Children, listener comes immediately after the question word. So, why he was late to the class. You know, already B1 changes into B2. He, third person singular, no? So, here we use was, the word was. Suppose if it's a plural, then we use one. Okay, why he was late to the class. no question mark. We did it in inverted commas. You came to know all these things in your previous class already. Okay, inquired. So the only thing you have to keep in your mind is how to change the word order while changing interrogative into from direct to direct into the reported speech. Now let us have a look at the second example. Her mother said, "What are you doing now? Come on, tell me what is the tense of this question here, children?" Yeah, present continuous. Now her mother asked. You can use asked here. Her mother asked what she was doing then. Here, just as in our earlier example, here also the word order changes while changing it into reported speech. Her mother asked what she was doing then. What she was are becomes was doing, now becomes then. Adverbs, adverb changes, no? There will be change in the adverb of time and adverb of places. Now refers to time, now becomes then. So now let us have a look at the third example, children. His father said, "When have you finished your work? Now come on, tell me the tense of the verb here, children." Yeah, it's the present perfect tense. Good. So his father asked, "When?" As it is, and come on, yeah, very good. Here comes he, because you refers to son, no? His father said. Even though his father said to his son, if it's not given, we can imagine that he is saying it to his son. His father said, "When have you finished your work?" When he had, you refers to his son. So he have finished becomes had finished. Have finished becomes had finished. Yeah, present perfect changes into past perfect, no children? So no question mark, no inverted commas, and question becomes a statement here. And by changing question into statement, there will be changing the word order. And you have come to know about already how these tenses change. Present simple to past simple, present continuous into past continuous, and present perfect into past perfect, children. Isn't it? Now let us have a look at the fourth example. He said to her, "How long have you been studying in this school?" Now come on, tell me the tense of this sentence, children. Yeah, very good. Present perfect continuous. Now come on, tell me, while changing present perfect continuous, what change does it take place? Come on, tell me, children, in reported speech. Yeah, it changes into past perfect continuous tense. Okay, good, children. Now let us have a look at this. He inquired her. We can write her or ask him. Inquired or asked here. He inquired her of how long. Question was same. And come on, very good. Here the order changes. Here you refers to, who does the word you refer to here? Listener. Who is the listener? Her. So what is the subjective form of her? She. So how long she have been becomes had been studying in this school, in that school, at the beloved place here. This school becomes that school. Okay. Now these are the changes that take place while changing interrogatives into reported speech when they are given in present tense, children. So I think you have understood well. Now let us have a look at the questions that start with the helping verb, children. Okay. Now look at this example. The teacher said, "Are you late? Are you late? Come on. What is the question word here? Are." Yes. So here the teacher inquired. We can write here if or whether by changing help when helping verbs are as question words. When helping verbs are used as question words, here comes if or whether as conjunction, children. If or whether. If or whether. So here you can write if or whether. You can write any conjunction word. The teacher inquired if. Here see. No question word. And it is, yeah, B form. B1 is used as question word here. So if we use conjunction between these two here. In between these two. So if she, just as in our previous examples. Here this word, as the, here also in these examples word order, there is change in the word order, no children? In the same here also there will be change in the word order. So if she was late, is becomes was late. Here if we added conjunction if or whether, no? So here this subject, this listener comes next to the question word. So yes, if she was late. Next here, yes, are you late becomes the teacher inquired if she was late. There is no question word, there are no inverted commas, and that question becomes a statement. And while using these helping verbs as question words, we use the conjunction if or whether. Just you start the statement using if or whether, and next to these helping verbs again comes in the sentence. We should not delete them. Keep that point in your mind. So if she was late. Next, so look at the second example. Her friend said to her, "Is your father in now? Come on, try to change it into reported speechular." Yeah, her friend inquired her. Her friend inquired her of if your father means your father. Yeah, listener's father. Who is the listener here? Her. Yes, her father. Her friend inquired her of if her father is becomes was no. So was ill. No question mark. No inverted comma children. Next, let us have a look at the third example. He said to her, "How long have you been studying here?" Yes. In which tense is it? Come on, tell me. Yeah, present perfect continuous children. He said to her. He inquired her of how long. Here is a question. Question word. How long have you been studying in here? How long she had been studying there? It's not a helping verb here. It's a question word. How long? Shall we go with the helping verb now, children? Yeah, as question word. Come on. Try to give one example, children. Okay, we shall write here. It will be convenient for you. Comfortable. We can feel comfortable. Come on. Tell me. One question in present perfect tense using helping verb. Yeah. Have you finished your work? He said to her, have you finished your work? Have you finished your work? Come on. Have you finished your work? Come on, children. He said to her, have you finished your work? He asked, come on, change it. He asked her, yeah, if comes here, no, if or whether, we can write, if or whether. Come on, tell me, who is the listener here? Who does this word refer to here? Yeah, her. That means she. If she, come on, have finished becomes had finished. Had finished. Yes. Your work becomes her work. Yeah. Her work. Full stop. No question mark. No inverted commas. Okay. Now, okay, children, is it clear to you? Come on, tell me. Let us revise all these examples once again. Yeah. Shall we write one more sentence in present continuous using helping verb? Come on, try to tell me. Yeah. She said to her mother. She said to her mother, are you going to market? Are you going to market? Try to change it into reported speech, children. Yeah, she asked her mother, come on, if or whether, word order. There will be change in the word order, no? Yes, if she. You refers to mother, no? So if she, are becomes was, she, third person singular, past tense, present tense becomes past tense. Going to market. Going to market. Okay, children. Now, present continuous changes into past continuous. Present simple changes into past simple. Present continuous changes into past continuous. Present perfect changes into past perfect. Present perfect continuous changes into past perfect continuous, children. Isn't it? I think it's very clear to you, children. If you have any difficulty at understanding, you pause the video and go through all those examples right from the beginning, and it will be very clear to you, children. And let's revise it once again. These are the changes that take place while changing the given sentence from direct speech into indirect speech. Let's come to the first point. If the reporting verb is in present tense, there will be no change in the tense of the given verb, as we have already discussed it. And the second point, if the reporting verb is V2 and if the given sentence is universal fact, principle or any statement given by the scientists, then also there will be no change in the tense of the given verb while changing it into indirect speech. Next, let's come to other sentences. Except universal facts or truths or principles, if the given verb is, reporting verb is in past tense, then these changes do take place. I told you already, all be forms, B1 changes into B2, do forms changes into did, possessive has, have changes into had, and this can becomes could, will becomes would, shall becomes should, may becomes might. Okay, children, it's very clear to you. Next, suppose if in the given sentence verb is in present tense, it becomes past simple. That means present simple becomes past simple. V1 changes into V2. And if the given sentence is in present continuous, that means we use B1 plus verb being form, no children. Then it changes into B2 and verb being form. That is nothing but past continuous. Next, let's come to the next one. If the given sentence is has plus verb 3, that means if it's a present perfect tense, it becomes had plus V3, that means it's a past perfect. And if the in the given sentence, if the verb is has been verb being form, that's nothing but present perfect continuous. It changes into had been verb being form, that's nothing but past perfect continuous tense. Okay, children, if the given sentence is past simple, it becomes had plus V3. We can go next in the next session. Okay, children, next let's have a look at the adverbial changes also. Time, suppose if the time mentioned is now, it changes into then. Today becomes the day, yesterday becomes the day before or the previous day. Next week or month or year becomes the following week, month or year, basing on the given phrase. Last week becomes the previous week, last month becomes previous month, and last year becomes the previous year. Ego becomes before. Next, let's come to places. Here becomes there. And pronouns, demonstrative pronouns, this becomes that, these becomes those. Here one exception is there, children. Now, this, here, they do not change if the reporter is at the same place at the time of speech. So, keeping all these things in your mind, try to change the given sentences into reported speech. Till now, we have discussed, about how to change direct speech into indirect speech in the areas of present simple. Let's revise it once again.